الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحابته المباركين ومن دعا بدعوته الحمد لله. We're sitting with people who are memorizing the Quran or have completed their memorization, as I understand, isn't it? Who has completed here? And who is about, to complete soon? Who is on 25 up? And who is 10 and up? And who is 5 and up? So mashallah, it's almost everyone. Jazakallah khair. It's almost everyone. Mashallah, is sooner or later will be Hafaz of the Book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that the one who has memorized the Quran has encompassed prophethood between his flanks. Man hafidha al-Quran faqad haza an-nubuwwata bayna jambay. He has encompassed prophethood between his sides. Except that he does not receive revelation. And Imam al-Shatibi rahimahullah, great scholar of Quran and Qira'at, says about the people of the Quran, says, وَإِنَّ كِتَابَ اللَّهِ أَوْثَقُ شَافِعٍ وَأَغْنَى غَنَاءٍ وَاهِبًا مُتَفَضِّلًا. That the Book of Allah is the best intercessor, is the best thing that you can produce with you on the day of Qiyamah. وَأَغْنَى غَنَاءٍ وَاهِبًا مُتَفَضِّلًا. And it is the best richness and wealth that you can have. وَخَيْرُ جَلِيسٍ لَا يُمَلُّ حَدِيثُهُ وَتَرْدَادُهُ يَزْدَادُ فِيهِ تَجَمُّلًا. And it is the best thing that you can sit with, you can spend your time in the company of, is the Quran. And وَتِرْدَادُهُ يَزْدَادُ فِيهِ تَجَمُّلًا. By repeating it, it becomes more beautiful. The more you repeat it, the more beautiful it becomes. وَتَرْدَادُهُ يَزْدَادُ فِيهِ تَجَمُّلًا وَحَيْثُ الْفَتَى يَرْتَاعُ فِي ظُلُمَاتِهِ مِنَ الْقَبْرِ يَلْقَاهُ سَنًا مُتَهَلِّلًا. That on the, in the day when you leave this world and you are in your grave and everyone is fearful, you will find the Book of Allah coming to you, embodying as a man, sitting with you, showing light to you in your grave. وحيث الفتى يرتاع في ظلماته من القبر يلقاه سنا متهللا هنيئا مريئا والداك عليهما ملابس أنوار من التاج والحلى. Like blessed is the one who memorizes the Quran, his parents will be crowned with crowns of light on the day of Qiyamah. فما ظنكم بالنجل عند جزائه أولئك أهل الله والصفوة الملا. Then what do you think about the son? If the parents of a person who memorizes the Quran are given crowns of light on the day of Qiyamah, then what is about the son? Because the Quran is so important and is a gift of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that indicates that Allah has selected and elected and chosen you to be gifted with the Quran. ثم أورثنا الكتاب الذين اصطفينا من عبادنا. We have given the Quran to those whom we have selected from amongst our slaves. So you have been selected, you've been elected by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to have the Quran, to memorize the Quran, to be called Ahlul Quran, the family of the Quran. Just like when someone is the family of a king, or someone is the family of a prime minister, or a family of the imam, or the family of an important person, they always give them focus. The media is always around them. Why? Because they are not just normal people. They're the family of someone. And because they are the family of someone, being the family of someone, they have to behave in a specific way. They can't just behave like everyone. Like the family of a queen or a king, the royalties, they have to behave in a specific way. Why? Because they're always in the public eye. They're always in the public eye. And because you are the family of the Quran, you got to behave in a specific way. Not because you are only in the public eye. You will be in the public eye. But because you are in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You are in the sight of Allah. You are in the sight of the malaika. You are in the sight of the prophets and messengers. You are always watched. Not for the bad reasons, but for the good reasons. What is expected from you is not expected from normal people. What is expected from you has to suit who you are. Imagine if a person is a graduate of a specific school of learning, like Harvard or Oxford or Cambridge, and he comes out, what do you expect from him? Why do companies and institutions hire the graduates of that school? Because the fact that they have been associated with that school, with that university, means that the quality of their knowledge is of a specific caliber. You being associated with the Quran should mean that the caliber of your character or the quality of your character has to be of a certain caliber. If it falls down, it will not only bring shame to you, it will bring shame to the people of the Quran. And so people will say, look, this is a hafiz of the Quran. You see how the people of the Quran are? So in fact, you're not bringing shame only to yourself, but it's for everyone. You're damaging even the image of the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us that the people of the Quran should be of the excellent character. Obedience and respect to their parents. Obedience and respect to the people in the street. Mercy and respect and fairness and justice. They shouldn't be, like I know that most of you are young people, alhamdulillah, and we live in a world that is full of distractions, attractions and distractions, things that are taking us up and down, right? We should, yes, possibly our resistance to the allurements of the world are really weak, is really, really weak, because we're humans at the end of the day. But we should struggle to be the best, to minimize these distractions in our lives. One of the duties that we have after we have completed the Hifz of the Quran, or since we are in the process of the Hifz of the Quran, is to maintain the Quran, to keep the Quran. You know, the Prophet ﷺ said that the worst person who will be brought on the day of Qiyamah is someone who has memorized one surah and then he forgot it. That's the worst sin a person can commit, is to memorize something and then to forget it. And two, to reflect and to think to understand what you're reciting. You know, back in the days when some of our brothers used to come and say, Sheikh, I have memorized the Quran. I say to him, okay, then he said, I just memorized it. I say, so do we have a new cassette tape? Because if you just memorize it, you're repeating it like a parrot. We don't want a new set of cassette tapes. We have loads and loads and loads of cassette tapes and CDs, isn't it? But we need a manifestation of the Quran, a person. Why are we so keen to have Hufaz of the Quran? If it's about just memorization, just the copying of the voice, we could have loads and loads of cassette tapes and that would be more professional than you, right? They wouldn't even make mistakes. Because you play a CD, does it make a mistake? But why do we want people to memorize the Quran? Because we want people to manifest the Quran so that when they teach, they don't just teach the words, they teach the character. Each and every one of us, including myself, the first teacher that we had was the Quran teacher. And the one who has left an imprint, an impression in our life, is the one who taught us the Quran. Why? Because your relationship with your Quran teacher is a very intimate relationship. Like when you attend a course by a sheikh or something, just attend the course and go. But your Quran teacher stays with you like for 2, 3, 4, 5 years. And you see him on a daily basis. So the impression that he leaves in you, and the fawaid, the benefits, and the good things that he leaves with you, you work with them till the rest of your life. I remember my first Quran teacher, the first sheikh that I studied with and I got ijazah from, was a sheikh who actually, I remember his date of birth and his date of death. He was born on 5th of May, 1932. And he died on the 7th of October, 2012. He lived for 80 years. And subhanAllah, some of the things that he taught me and some of the things that I saw in his company and some of the benefits that I learned from his example are beyond imagination. His etiquette and his respect and his adab at this very late age of 80, at 70. A man at his 70 and he would go upstairs and bring the tea and he's unable to walk to come and serve me the tea. And I'm at the age of his children. Actually, his children were older than me. But he would come and look after me. I used to go to him on Fridays. And I remember once I was so tired that I started reciting Surah Al-An'am, the whole of Surah Al-An'am, and I was half asleep. And the Shaykh was so merciful and so careful and so caring that I used to learn from his example and I used to learn from his care. And he actually, after I recited, he said, "Son, have a bit of sleep. I'm going to go upstairs, have a bit of sleep. I'm going to go to my wife upstairs. I need to do something. You have a bit of sleep to freshen up and then you wake up to continue your recitation." Now, subhanAllah, and when I went to him, he was so busy. He's occupied literally every day of the week. He said, "Look, I have students for the whole week. The only time I'm free is Friday. But I don't mind receiving you on Friday. I will give you the whole of my Friday." So I used to go to him after Fajr every Friday and finish at Isha. I will go to pray Salatul Jum'ah with him in the masjid and take his hand. He's 70s. Like, I take his hand and go home and start reciting. And he would tell me, I say, "Maulana, you can go upstairs and have your lunch." He says, come, have lunch with me." I used to say, no. So he would, after a long deliberation, even if he agrees, khalas, he goes to have lunch. So he will say, "Recite while I'm having lunch." I say, "How can I recite while you're having lunch?" He said, no, I'm upstairs." He's upstairs. And I would recite. Wallahi, I remember that once he had to go to the toilet. And he said, "Recite." I said, "Sheikh, no, just recite." And he went, and I made a few mistakes. So he came out after he finished the toilet and he had wudu. He said, "Oh, remember this ayah, this ayah, this ayah, this ayah." If I tell you things about the people of the Quran, you will be absolutely surprised. You will be absolutely surprised. They mentioned that Imam Alamuddin al-Sakhawi, a student of Imam al-Shatibi, rahimahullah, Alamuddin al-Sakhawi, Ali ibn Abd al-Samad, Abu al-Hasan, Ali ibn Abd al-Samad al-Sakhawi, was born in 575 and died in 643. He was born in Egypt and he died in Asham in Syria. They say that he was so smart that he used to ride his donkey and two students on both sides, both reciting at the same time. One is reciting one recitation and the other is reciting different recitation. And he's responding to both of them and correcting both of them at the same time. That's how the people of the Quran were so sharp. Imam al-Shatibi, that's what you get. That's if you are a person who takes the Quran and applies the Quran and stands by the principles of the Quran, this is what Allah gives you. Imam al-Shatibi rahimahullah is one of the great imams of Quran ever. And Imam al-Qastallani wrote a book on the called Al-Fath al-Mawahibi fi manaqib al-Imam al-Shatibi, the divine gifts on the story of Imam al-Shatibi, his lifetime. He wrote the life story of Imam al-Shatibi. Imam al-Shatibi rahimahullah ta'ala was blind, but he was very sharp, absolutely sharp. They even said, like one of his students came and he asked him a question on usul al-fiqh, and he gave him an answer. So he said, "Do you know usul al-fiqh as well?" He said, "I memorized a camel load of books on usul al-fiqh, only on the principles of Islamic jurisprudence." So he said, "If you have memorized that much books, why don't you teach usul fiqh?" He said, "No, with the Quran, I don't need any partner. I don't need anything to share my mind with the Quran." And they say that Imam al-Shatibi rahimahullah ta'ala was so sharp-minded that one of his students came, and it was the habit of the students, they come first, they're served first. So whoever goes to the masjid or to the madrasa early, he will read to the sheikh early. That student, he narrated that story. He said, "One day I went and I was the first person. And the sheikh came in and he said, 'Where is the second student? Let the second read first.' So that student was really confused. That's not the habit of the sheikh. He normally lets the first one to arrive to be the first to recite. Then he thought, 'What have I done?' He thought in his mind. And he remembered that he woke up in a state of major impurity and he forgot to take ghusl before he goes to the school. So he rushed to the school without ghusl. So he said, 'Astaghfirullah al-Azim.' Went quickly to his house, had the shower, came back. As soon as he stepped into the school, the sheikh is blind. He said, 'Where is the student who came first today? Let him recite now.' So surprised. He was so surprised. And we can sit here and talk about the imams of Qira'at and the imams of the Quran that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has gifted him with loads and loads of things. But these gifts will not come unless the heart is full of light. And the heart will not be full of light unless the body is in the state of obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As we all know the story of Imam Shafi'i radiallahu ta'ala an, when he said, Shakawtu ila waki'in, su'a hifzi, fa'arshadani ila tarki al-ma'asi. I complained to my teacher Waki' that of my bad memory. So he guided me to leave sins. وَقَالَ أَعْلَمْ بِأَنَّ الْعِلْمَ نُورٌ. He said, bear in mind that knowledge is light. وَنُورُ اللَّهِ لَا يُهْدَى لِعَاصِيٍ. And the light of Allah is not given to a disobedient person. If you want to be connected to the Quran, to be connected to knowledge, you have to prepare yourself, to qualify yourself. And that does not happen unless you are a good person. When you sit with the Quran, you sit with full adab and etiquette. When you behave, people can say, this is a man of the Quran. He is a unique person. And we conclude with the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in which he said, يَنْبَغِي لِحَافِظُ الْقُرْآنِ أَنْ يُعْرَفَ بِلَيْلِهِ. The memorizer, the hafiz of the Quran, should be known at night with his prayer, when people are asleep. وَبِجِدِّهِ إِذَا لَهَا اللَّهُونَ. With his seriousness, when people are just laughing. With his seriousness, when people are just enjoying their life and spending their days, he should be serious about his life, because he's got the Quran. He appreciates that jewel. He appreciates this great gift of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الذين يتلون كتاب الله وأقاموا الصلاة وأنفقوا مما رزقناهم سرا وعلانية يرجون تجارة لن تبور. ليوفيهم أجورهم ويزيدهم من فضله إنه غفور شكور. والذي أوحينا إليك من الكتاب هو الحق مصدقا لما بين يديه. إن الله بعباده لخبير بصير. ثم أورثنا الكتاب الذين اصطفينا من عبادنا ثم أورثنا الكتاب الذين اصطفينا من عبادنا فمنهم ظالم لنفسه ومنهم مقتصد ومنهم سابق بالخيرات بإذن الله ذلك هو الفضل الكبير. صدق الله العظيم.